Hi, welcome to Sakshi FIIT NEET Academy. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the IUPAC system of nomenclature. We know that IUPAC system of nomenclature is very, very important in organic chemistry. To reach a maximum knowledge in organic chemistry, that means to understand a complete all chapters in organic chemistry. First step, that is a hybridization of carbon. Second step, a classification of organic molecules. Then third step, IUPAC nomenclature. So without IUPAC nomenclature, it's very, very difficult to write a name for any organic molecule. So here, that IUPAC system of nomenclature has a particular rules to write a name for any organic molecule. What are that rules and how to write a IUPAC nomenclature? We will discuss in detail. So this topic is very, very important. Without knowing these rules, it's very, very difficult. So you can follow some tricks, those helpful for giving name for basic molecules. But if you understand the complete rules of IUPAC system, that is IUPAC nomenclature, then it's very easy to write a name for any organic molecule. So let's begin. What is IUPAC system of nomenclature and what are the rules are existed in that system of nomenclature? Here IUPAC system of nomenclature, our organic molecules here, this IUPAC stands for International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Pure and Applied Chemistry. So here, what are the rules and how to name a organic molecule? First, here to name any organic molecule, we need to follow the steps. After following steps, the last we need to follow the order of nomenclature. Order of nomenclature. So what is order of nomenclature? In organic chemistry, in IUPAC system, we have a particular terminology. That is a prefix, a word root and a suffix. Again, the prefix classified into four types. That is primary prefix, secondary prefix, number prefix and a numerical prefix. Then word root. Then next, again suffixes. That is primary suffix, secondary suffix, number suffix and a numerical suffix. This is a terminology. So before this, we need to follow a few steps. So what are that steps? We will discuss in clearly. So to understand them easily, first I'm taking a molecule and I'll try to name the molecule based on a particular steps. After that, we will discuss complete order of a nomenclature. What is primary prefix, secondary prefix, number prefix, numerical prefix and what is word root and what is the suffix, that is primary, secondary, number and numerical. Then finally, it's very easy to write a name. So this complete system of nomenclature will be done in a three video lectures. In first video lecture, basics, that is what are the steps and simple classification, and we'll complete up to prefixes and word root. Then in the next video, suffixes. In the next video, a complete applying a nomenclature rules by taking an examples. To understand that, here I'm taking an example, that is a molecule. Here this is a molecule contain aldehyde functional group on this cyclic chain and has a particular substituents. Here we have a two bromine substituents at this carbon. And here this carbon bonded to something other functional group. So how can I name this molecule? To name the molecule, here we have a steps which are a primary steps. That is first step. Example, this is a molecule. What is the first step? The first step is selection of parent chain. Selection of parent chain. So this is a molecule. First, I need to select a parent chain. Then what is the next step? Next step, identification of substituents. So out of all substituents, which is major substituent and which are secondary substituents. So what is the second step? Identification of primary and secondary substituents. So here primary substituents means major functional group, secondary substituent means secondary functional groups which we are considering as a common substituents. Next, numbering to the parent chain. So after numbering to the parent chain, then the final step, follow the order of IUPAC terminology. So these are the steps to give a name for any organic molecule. So first molecule, then go to selection of parent chain, then identification of primary and secondary substituents. Here primary substituent means major functional group, secondary substituents means that is secondary functional groups which we are considering as a substituents. Next, numbering to the parent chain. So after this we need to number based on the functional group and based on the chain. Now here the last step, follow the order of IUPAC terminology. So what is IUPAC terminology, we'll discuss in detail. By following this, I'm just trying to name the molecule. So here this is a parent chain. First, identification of parent chain. Next, identification of, that is selection of parent chain. Then next, identification of primary and secondary substituents. These are primary substituent which is a aldehyde major functional group, and these are secondary substituents, two bromines I'm just considering as a substituents. Next, we have a unsaturation in the parent chain. So after that, numbering to the parent chain. Based on the rules, I just numbering to this molecule means on the parent chain is a first number, because major functional group bonded carbon become first carbon. First and the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So numbering is completed. Next, follow the order of IUPAC terminology. Now I am following that order. Based on the order, here I am trying to give a name. That is, at fourth position we have a two bromines, 4, 4, two bromines, that is di. So bromines means bromo, dibromo. Go to parent chain. The parent chain is cyclic, so cyclo. So in parent chain we have a six number of carbons, it's become hex. So in that parent chain we have unsaturation at second position and at a fifth position, 2, 5. Two times we have unsaturation, that is double bond di. Unsaturation is double bond, so in, and finally major functional group at first position, that is a aldehyde, including this carbon, become carbaldehyde. So this is the IUPAC name for this molecule. For by following these rules, it's very easy to write a name. So as I know the rules, that's what I can write a name. So you are a beginners. First, we need to learn how to select a parent chain, then how to identify. Identification is easy. Now, how to number into the parent chain, then what are the terminology, means what is the terminology and what are the terms are existed in this terminology, like a word root, prefix, suffix. Again, in the prefix, primary prefix, secondary prefix, number prefix, numerical prefix, then word root, next suffix. Primary suffix, secondary suffix, number suffix, and a numerical suffix. This is the terminology in IUPAC nomenclature. We need to learn in detail of this terminology. After that, go to how to select a parent chain, then how to number to the parent chain. By knowing this terminology, selection rule of parent chain, and number into the parent chain, then it's very easy to write a name for any organic molecule. So based on the rules, this is a molecule and this is a IUPAC name. So now we'll start first we need to discuss about a terminology, then after terminology selection rules of parent chain, then rules for numbering to the parent chain. So shall I start a terminology? Now here the terminology actually classified into three parts, that is word root, this is a main base, explains about the parent chain. After word root, suffix, then before word root, prefix. So prefix, word root and a suffix. Again these prefix are classified into four types. One is a primary prefix, the next secondary prefix, then number prefix the last one numerical prefix. So here prefix is classified into four types: primary, secondary, number and numerical. Now again suffix also four types, that is same primary suffix, very easy, secondary suffix, then number suffix, the last one is numerical suffix. So this is the terminology, word root. So whatever the information before word root, that is called a prefix. After word root, called a suffix. So what is word root here? Word root, simple, explain or gives the information about, give the information about number of carbons present in the parent chain. So this is by word root. So now we will start from word root, then we will discuss one by one in detail. So shall I start with this word root? Prefixes, suffixes and in between word root is there. First we will discuss about the word root, then prefix, suffix, finally we will write these all the key points, terms in a order, then we will move to how to select a parent chain, next how to number to the parent chain, finally the complete naming of molecules with examples. So now here I'm just erasing this. Here what is word root? Word root here, same example I'm taking here, molecule. By using this example, we will discuss all the terms. So I what is the name? Just before we had the name, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now here I'm writing a name, that is 4, 4, 4, 4, dibromo, cyclo, cyclic, hex, 2, 5, diene, carbaldehyde. Carbaldehyde, that is the IUPAC name of that molecule. Now here what is word root? Word root is nothing but number of carbons present in this parent chain. Number of carbons present in a parent chain. How many carbons are present in this parent chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is hex. So if you are taking example, hex is a word root. So 6 number of carbons are there. So we are just taking a word root, that is a hex. If we have a different number of carbons, then how to write a word root? For that, if n number of carbons, that is n equal to 1, n equal to number of carbons, n equal to 1, the word root become mith. If n equal to 2, the word root become ith. If n equal to 3, the word root become prop. If n equal to 4, it's a but. N equal to 5, the number of carbons in a parent chain is a 5, then the word root is pent. If the number of carbons present in a parent chain is 6, the word root is hex. If the number of carbons are present in a parent chain is 7, this is hepta. Now coming to next, if the number of carbons are present in the parent chain is 8, then it's oct. Now number of carbons are 9 in a parent chain, then it's non. Number of carbons present in the parent chain 10, it's a tec. If it is 11, undec. If it is 12, dodec. If it is 13, tridec. Like we have up to 100, but maximum molecules up to 10 is enough. Up to 10 is enough. So here, what is word root? Simple, it gives the information about a number of carbons present in the parent chain by giving its a word root name. That is, if a only one carbon in a parent chain, meth, two carbons ith, three carbons prop, four carbons but, five carbons pent, that is six carbons hex, seven carbons hepta, eight carbons oct, nine carbons non, 10 dec, 11 undec, dodec, tridec, like a we have a continuation. Up to 10 is enough. So simple here, it explain number of carbons, explains the number of carbons present in parent chain by giving a word root. So this is the story of word root. So hope you understand what is word root. Simple, number of carbons present in the parent chain, that is expressed in a word root by this terminology, that is meth, eth, prop, but, pent, hex, hepta, oct, non, dec, undec, dodec, like a continuation. So this is a word root. Now we will take a prefixes. What is prefix and how to identify what type of prefix, whether primary, secondary, number or numerical. So may I remove this part? Now here next, prefixes. Here prefixes, that means prefixes word root suffixes word root total number of carbons. So number of carbons before word root, whatever the information by this prefix about substituents and their position on parent chain, and cyclic or acyclic. So what is the information by this prefix? This prefix explains that total how many substituents are there and what are the position of what is the position of substituent on a parent chain, and what is the arrangement of that number of carbons, cyclic or acyclic. If cyclic, then mentioned with a cyclo. So that is information by prefix given in a four types, means classified four types, that is number prefix, primary prefix, next secondary prefix, then number prefix, numerical prefix. That is total information given by following these four types. So here what is prefix, primary, secondary, numbering and number prefix and numerical prefix. We will learn about these four types of prefixes. Okay, so here I'm taking up prefixes. So have you understand? Prefixes means simple on parent chain. What are the substituents? Secondary substituents and their position, and about the parent chain, whether it's cyclic or acyclic. That is information by prefixes, but this is classified into four types, that is primary, secondary, number and a numerical prefix. I'm first taking a primary prefix. What is primary prefix? Simple, here again I'm taking same example. This is a molecule, this is a IUPAC name. See, hex, that means word root. So before hex we have a cyclo, means the arrangement of these parent carbons, whether cyclic or acyclic. If cyclic, then we need to mention cyclo. This is called a primary prefix. So here what is prefix? Explains about parent carbons arrangement, whether cyclic or acyclic. We can apply only in the case of cyclic, then this primary prefix become cyclo. So did you understand what is primary prefix? If the parent chain is cyclic, then we need to apply primary prefix as a cyclo before word root. So before word root, after primary suffix, immediately we need to take a word root. So that is the information by this primary prefix. So in this example, cyclo is a primary prefix. Next, secondary prefix. Secondary prefix is nothing but all the substituents, secondary substituents on a parent chain. Here this is example. In this example, which are comes under secondary prefix? See here, bromo. The secondary substituents which are present on a parent chain is given in the form of secondary prefix. So in this example, bromo is a secondary prefix. Like we have other halogens like a chloro, bromo, iodo, hydroxy and methyl groups, ethoxy group, like a propoxy group. These all are comes under secondary prefix. So here it gives the information about substituents on parent chain. So example here, bromo. Like I'm taking other examples. Example, if it is chlorine is on parent chain, represented with chloro, the secondary prefix become chloro. If it is bromine is there, bromo. Iodine is there, it's become iodo. If we have a fluorine, then fluoro. If it is a only alkyl group is there, only alkyl group is there, alkyne. That means if it is CH3 is there, it's become methyl. If CH3, CH2 is there, based on the number of carbons, two carbons means ethyl, alkyl group, ethyl. If three carbons are there, substituents, we are considering as a substituents, it's become propyl, like a, I'm taking a, here, if we have a OR, there is alkoxy group. If it is OCH3, substituent is there on a parent chain, it's become methoxy, word root with a oxy, methoxy. If we have a CH3, CH2 bonded to oxygen, these bonded oxygen connected to parent chain, then it's become ethoxy, like a propoxy, butoxy. If it is cyclic carbon bonded to oxygen, bonded to parent chain, cyclopropoxy, cyclobutoxy, cyclopentoxy. So here, what is secondary prefix? Just a naming of substituents on a parent chain. Naming of substituents on a parent chain like a bromo, that is a secondary prefix. Example, chloro, bromo, iodo, fluoro. If alkyl groups are there, that is methyl, alkyl group, ethyl, propyl, like a butyl, that is pentyl. If these are cyclic, cyclopropyl, cyclobutyl, cyclopentyl. If it is oxygen bonded to methyl group and this oxygen bonded to parent chain, then methoxy. If two carbons are bonded to oxygen, this oxygen bonded to parent chain, ethoxy, like propoxy, butoxy. And here, if this is cyclic bonded to the oxygen, that is bonded to parent chain, that is become cyclopropoxy, cyclobutoxy, cyclopentoxy. If other function groups are there, then how to name as a secondary prefix? That we will learn while discussing a secondary suffixes. In a secondary suffixes, we will take a, if the major function group as a suffix, what is a name? As a prefix, what is a name? I will give a table. So there we'll discuss for a functional group. Here I'm taking commonly for a halogens and a simple alkyl group and alkoxy groups. So this is a secondary prefix. Next. So here next coming to number prefix. That is third one, number prefix. Yeah, here primary prefix explains about a arrangement of parent chain, whether cyclic or acyclic. If it is cyclic, then we need to mention primary prefix. Next, secondary prefix gives the information about substituents, which substituents are present on the parent chain. Like now, here number prefix, it is nothing but simple. It explains a position of that substituents. So on the parent chain, if the first, at a first position, at second position, at a third position. Example here, in this molecule, now see 4, 4, 4, here we have a 2 bromines at a fourth position. Okay, that is a number prefix. Simple here, number prefix explains the position of substituents on a parent chain, this is called a number prefix. So here in this example, 4, 4 dibromo cyclo hexa, 2, 5 diene carbaldehyde. In this IUPAC nomenclature, in prefix 4, 4, both the bromine atoms are bonded to fourth carbon. So that is the information by number prefix. Now coming to numerical prefix. Is also very, very easy. See here, this 4, 4, this is a number prefix, gives the information about substituent position. Now second, see here, dibromo. If there is a more than one same type of substituents are there, then we need to use a numerical prefix. If there is more than one same type of functional substituent, there is more than one same type of substituent, then if it is two substituents are same, di. If three are same, tri, tetra, penta, like a. If here two substituents are there which are same, then we need to use a di. This is for a numerical prefix. If there are three substituents are there, same substituents, then tri. Example here, dibromo. Both the substituents are bromine, same type of substituents. Those are two. That's what we are using a numerical prefix, that is di. If three bromines are there, then tri. If four bromines are there, then tetra. If five bromines are there, penta. Like if it is two, di, three, tri, four, a tetra, that is five, penta, six, hexa, seven, hepta, like that. This numerical prefix gives the information about a number of substituents on a parent chain. Again, in that number of substituents, same type of substituents are more than one, then for two substituents it's di, for three substituents it tri, for four substituents it's tetra, for five substituents it penta, hexa, hepta. This is the numerical prefix. So hope you understand well what are prefixes and word root. In the next video, we'll discuss about the suffixes and that is how to select a parent chain and how to number to the parent chain. Then we will practice by taking some examples. Thank you.